Motorists are being reassured, despite cracks appearing in the Westgate Bridge, under increasing traffic loads. A Vic Roads report has been revealed, calling for $150 million in repairs.
Cracking under the pressure, shouldering peak hour loads for more than 30 years has taken its toll on the Westgate Bridge.
There are needs for ongoing maintenance on the bridge. That's been known for some time.
Bridge users are being assured there's no immediate risk.
These are hairline cracks in the actual steel. They do need to be treated, but they are not of any concern at all at this point in time.
It's been revealed a report to the Roads Minister a year ago called for $10 million repair work each year to combat fatigue cracking for the next 15 years. The government says it's currently spending about $8 million a year, accusing the opposition of scaremongering.
It doesn't highlight that there is a safety issue with the bridge. He has raised that. He has raised the issue of the integrity of the bridge.
An increase in traffic has been blamed for the wear and tear, adding to pressure for a second river crossing.
Doing nothing, hiding, refusing to govern, that's not leadership.
The Premier's dilemma, whether to build another bridge or go underground.
We're not going to come up with a tunnel to nowhere.
I reckon they should do a tunnel. Yeah, a tunnel would be better.
In the meantime, motorists want the Westgate fixed.
Well, a few little cracks turn into big cracks eventually, don't they?
Yeah, try and fix this one first, yeah.
Nick Butler, 10 News.
And Nick joins us live now from the famous landmark. And Nick, what's the popular tip for an alternative to the Westgate?
Well, Helen, I spoke to a civil engineer just moments ago and he believes the government will opt for a tunnel rather than building a second bridge. Now, going underground is very expensive, but I'm told it's better for the environment, less destructive and will be a far more popular choice with drivers in the long run. So it's all in the hands of the government. Not many plans as yet. We'll have to watch this space behind me, but the early tip is a new tunnel and that's looking like a winner, Helen.
All right, thanks for that, Nick. 10's Nick Butler reporting live there.